and served as a home to the
Hello, Hello everyone. Cemetery across Welcome the back to Metal Gear Solid the Twin Snakes. In the last part, we did some stuff, and now we're here. Alright. Metal Gear is right in front of us, and we just got a codec call from Otacon. I'm also watching Ghost Adventures because I feel like it.
I'm not sure.
There definitely seems to be some type of activity here. I feel like something is extremely dangerous.
So we're here with John Riddle of the Riddle House.
My uncle came down here in 1920 and lived in the house. He was the superintendent of the cemetery. They even performed burial ceremonies in this room. At night, the stairs would creak. They couldn't keep any higher up in the house once the stairs started creaking. And the way he described it in the diary was that it made so much noise it sounded like somebody was grabbing a chain.
You actually assisted with the move of the Riddle House.
This video is probably going to be mostly codec calls, and that's it. I'm going to adjust my camera ever so slightly. There we go. Kind of, sort of. Anyways, there's some stairs. Let's walk up the stairs. And my TV is deciding to be an ass.
John told us the story of what seems to be one of these ghostly occurrences.
Early on in the beginning of the depression,
there we go.
And this guy came by and wanted to help out doing handiwork around the house. He was hired. Supposedly, he was having still some financial problems.
You're so dead.
Go along with that, and it finally just got too much for him.
Fuck.
And he evidently hung himself. Yeah.
How's it going?
There's been several sightings of what you want to call it, apparitions or something. We fear that it's Joseph, the guy who hung himself.
Suddenly, the connection to the moving ladders became clear.
The man who committed suicide in this house climbed up the ladder.
That was completely useless.
The ladder out from under me.
And the encounters escalated from there.
I saw a two-by-four
fall. Collect ammo and supplies. And maybe kill this guy that's over here.
I don't even know where it came from. It shouldn't have been where it was.
Yeah. How many missiles do we have? 40. Maxed out on them. Yay. Ooh. That sounds like his day has been completely wrecked, man. Ah, fuck.
We would open up that building in the morning and things would be broken, glass would be broken, locks would be on the floor.
So what you got?
And here the next day and things would be broken or in disarray.
Others were also eager to tell stories of what they've seen and heard.
You know, hear people talk about the gorilla house, about it being haunted. They always say they see a light. You know, something like that here.
Just as I thought.
They tell me they see people walking across the windows. The window frame's second story that they always say they see something.
The house is considered a missile. That way it can allow all sorts of international treaties.
And I
trace the house. Yes. But in fact,
that's been saying
that. That's not even the scariest
thing. In each room, you get a different feeling. There is something that why can't we when I
dun, dun, dun.
You hesitate before you walk in the door.
Look out, because we've had several sightings of a person, female, usually in a white outfit, with a white African doll walking around. It's like she's in pain constantly. People would see this person in white walking. They would go to approach, and the person wouldn't speed up or anything, but they'd either go around the building or they'd just.
Sometimes these encounters were closer than others.
They like to touch your hair.
What was your feelings when you felt this unseen force grab your hair?
I always ask to let her know I'm coming in.
The world.
We had an event here, a media day, where people were able to access through an American Historical Society photographs of this house going back to the turn of the century and earlier. Some of those photographs were put on a tent out here and covered for the unveiling. All of us who worked out here were visited by what looked like a fairly young couple.
Well, you shouldn't have made such a weapon.
When they announced the unveiling process, we looked for these people because we thought they would make a perfect backdrop for the camera. We could not find these people anywhere in the nation. In one of the photographs, it was 100% carbon copy of the people. None of us have seen them before. None of them saw us after, and they were not here during the ceremony.
I can't find the data anywhere on this network. I think the data is important. It's not being carefully recorded. Here at my inbox.
We have not found a person that does not have a paranormal experience inside this yesteryear village.
The terrorists have replaced the building warhead with a real warhead. Once they input the detonation code, they should be ready to launch.
We've had other people threaten to spend a night in here, but
the dummy warhead was designed to be identical to the real thing.
I'll make a suggestion to you when you go in. If you have access to an American flag,
it must be in a separate file.
Every time this is
open, Kodak calls. Anyways, I'd like to make an apology. Mainly because of my commentary and everything. I haven't been feeling all that all the greatest. And, yeah. Also, I'd like to talk about my rant video I made like about a month or so ago about Daniel Tosh. I think I was a bit too harsh whenever I was talking about, you know, everything. Me calling him, you know, not funny at all and a bad addition to the show. I've been watching it a little bit more often, and I just want to say a few things that I do like about the feller. I think I mentioned that I do like how in the little, you know, I'm going to use skits, for lack of a better word, he... Yeah, there's nothing that this person won't do for the sake of comedy, which I think that's a good thing. I should have acknowledged it a little bit more. And I also find that he doesn't care who he pisses off with what he says, which I think is also a quality that I find good. I mean, not everything he says is funny, but he's a lot funnier than most people, and I gave him far too little credit. So I just wanted to talk about that a little bit, and maybe in the future I'll try not to be as much of an ass. Anyways, this cutscene, Liquid Snake is very much alive. Good thing being exploded in a helicopter and falling hundreds of feet to an exploding explosion would have adverse effects on his health, but he's all fine and dandy and all happy, and he's like saying words and stuff. That could use $1 billion. In the next video, we'll talk about that stuff too.